Ah. Now we're looking at Frank's story. Come on, just make a decision. Which one? Jesus. The public footpath? And I can't go that way. And I can, actually. Never mind.
I messed up, Frank, but I done my time. They shouldn't keep on punishing me.
Some folk won't let go, Reese, and they've got nothing better to do than to poke their noses into other people's business. There's nothing you can do about it, son.
I'm doing a good job. I'm working hard. I swear, Mrs. Graves thinks I'll start nicking stuff if she turns her back for a second.
This is all right. She's one of the good ones.
Yeah, well, she's not exactly honest with her husband about what she gets up to.
None of that. You're angry about people judging you. Don't be so fast to judge others.
I'm sorry, Frank.
Keep your gob shut, your nose clean, and your head down. Do you think you can manage that?
Gob, nose, head. Got it.
And steer clear of that Rachel girl. If I've seen you two making eyes at each other, then so's her dad. And you don't want Sam Baker coming round after you. Now, pass me that soccer spanner and we'll see if we can get this wheel back on.
No, wait, what's that? What is that? It's a lunchbox. Completely inconsequential. I don't know why I lost my mind over that. Staying on the public footpath. Come on now. It's very orange out right now. What, no more music? I gotta say, this looks extremely photogenic. Like, holy shit. Now, either I'm very short, or these are very tall.
Can you see the observatory from there?
That's over the ridge, just past the windmill. You want to live near the station in case you need a quick getaway?
Something like that. So you and Steven, I'm sensing there's not a lot of love lost there, huh?
That's between him, me, and the cows.
You're gonna have to explain that one for me.
It's nobody else's business. Look, you seem all right to me. You don't want to worry about that lot in the village.
Provided I'm left alone, I'm happy. Steven's the one who likes to be at the center of things.
No change there, then.
Francis Appleton. You are a bad man. No wonder your sister won't talk to you.
It's his uncle. Got it. Okay, I thought she was his he was her husband. Actually, her brother. Okay. Now I'm getting the pieces together. I understand. This is a really pretty area. Very different from what we've seen so far. That's for sure. Like, everything's been very nice, at least in terms of graphical fidelity, but for the most part, it's just been kind of towns and streets and stuff. This is more of a countryside kind of appearance to it. A lot of trees, particle effects and whatnot. Ooh. Uh-oh, what we got? There we are.
Under the microscope, you could see how the light was following the cellular structure of its wings. The neural simplicity of the insects seems to prevent a full-blown infestation, so there's none of the hemorrhaging I'm seeing in the birds. But Steven's wrong. This isn't an attack. It's a byproduct of the attempt to communicate. getting smarter. It's learning as it adapts. I'm confident of a breakthrough soon.
Interesting. So what is this, like aliens then? Or some sort of alien life form? Kind of like that episode Midnight from Doctor Who. Something kind of breached into, if you don't really watch Doctor Who, there was this one episode where the Doctor's in this sort of shuttle area, and they're visiting this planet, and then this creature, whatever the hell it is, gets inside of the shuttle and takes over people's bodies. And at first doesn't really know anything about them, but very quickly begins to adapt and understand how they act. Really interesting. Obviously, it's not the exact same thing here, but it sounds kind of similar. If they're not going for a religious angle, which is what I thought at first. Also, apparently there's a running option. I was talking about that before, either last part of the part before that. But I've pressed all the buttons, and I can't seem to get it to go. So I'm not quite sure. How that's supposed to work. Huh. All right, Bucket. There's something over here, I remember. Yeah. Well, that little trailer, I guess. Whoa.
Breaker, Breaker 9, calling on 9. This is Lost Cowboy looking for anyone out there. Hello? Breaker 1-9, Breaker traveling Sherlock. Charlie, you out there? Over.
Hello? My family, my wife and kids.
Yeah, perfectly well what you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant. My own family.
Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff.
No.
Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you
stupid bastards.
If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
All right, also, I had a bit of a... I don't know what you would call it, just sort of a lapse in common sense. At the very beginning of this game, we were listening to Kate kind of narrate exactly what was happening, and I guess it just didn't put two and two together, and so I'm like 99% sure that we're playing as Kate right now, coming from the observatory, and I'm thinking most likely one of the characters that we'll be looking through the point of view of is Steven. And he's probably been taken since then. And most likely called an airstrike. And I'm just predicting the ending. Like, I don't know. But I have a feeling that what's probably going to end up happening is the end of this game is going to be the airstrike. And it's going to kill Kate. I could be wrong, though. Looks like there's something back there. There's a way to get in, I think. I mean, there's obviously something in there. Might not be pertaining to the story, but it looks like there are items, at least. And this is the second time I'm recording. I finished off, like, right at the beginning of Frank's story, back over there. And I'm picking it back up, and... I looked at some of the comments on what some people thought of this game, and most of them obviously haven't played it, but pretty much all of them were shitting on it, of course. That's obviously not too big of a shocker. But I've really been enjoying it so far. I've only played maybe like a third of the game up to this point, but the story has definitely caught my attention, and I've been enjoying myself so far. Obviously there was something up over there, like that I could climb on top of, but that's probably going to take me further down that way, and I haven't gone over this stuff quite yet, so I'm going to do this first. Is that a phone? No, I heard a phone somewhere. Ah, I think it's up here.
I hung up on Steven. He doesn't understand. Even if he were here to experience it directly, I'm still not sure he would. There has to be a way of consolidating, of offering reciprocal amplification to this signal.
All right, seems like she's lost her patience a little bit with her husband. Glad that didn't hurt me. That would have sucked. You know, my only concern is, like, I would go back over there and climb on top of that thing, but I don't know if I can come back. Is my only, like, big worry with it all. Ah, here we are.
The radio telescope in Tower 6 is burned out. The background radiation coming in from the Penrose region is off the scale. It's like mathematics is bending along with the light. Everything is bathed in a strange glow. My face is still numb from the burn.
The burn. Oh, maybe that could be what traveled through the telescope? Just a guess. If that is what actually happened, that is. What the hell? I have no idea what's going on in this room. You coming in here? Ah, upstairs. I'm just going to check around real quick. Be completely certain. What is this? Crazy. Okay, I can't open that. All right, upstairs it is. All right.
How's your sister, Frank?
We've not spoken since the funeral.
Ah, I see. Well, listen, I did rather wonder if you might do me a bit of a favor and check in on her, see if she's all right.
Dr. Wade, if they dropped the bomb, there'd be no left but cockroaches and Wendy Boyles.
It's a bit odd, really. There's an old chap, John Coles, regular visitor at Lakeside, went walkabout sometime last night. Now it appears Mrs. Boughton has done the same.
Enid? Well, that'd be clever. They amputated her leg last spring.
Yes, that's the thing. I've also got a surgery full of people with nosebleeds and headaches. The council are saying influenza, but I've been practicing for 35 years and I'm not convinced. I just wondered if you might pop by and see her.
Even if I did, do you really think she'd let me in?
Fine. Forget it. I'll see her. Leave it to me. Oh, and Frank, call the hospital and get them to collect all this stuff. It's been 8 months.
And I suppose that this was... Ah, shit, I can't remember his name. Wendy's husband. That was up here. That would make sense. What's out there? I think that's my next destination. Sorry, 1 second, I gotta adjust my mic stand real quick. Ugh. Sorry, I'm sure that was pretty loud. or annoying. Gotta conserve light. I keep on hearing noises, but... Alright, where are you going? This way? Here? Okay, go there. Yeah, I wish you were a little bit more precise with this stuff. It would make it a lot easier.
It's bloody England. You can't just stop the train, stop people traveling about the place. I don't like it, Frank. I don't like it at all.
Well, nobody likes it. No sense sweating cobs over it.
Folk all riled about it, giving me grief. I didn't stop the bloody trains, did I? And did they give me any warning? No, they bloody didn't. Yesterday, it's all like keeping calm, Howard, minor disruptions, and today it's all government edicts and not until further notice, and you'll manage. Half the village has vanished.
It's a couple of people. It's hardly half the village.
Oh, right now. You forget, I've seen things. I was in the Falklands. I tell you, I got out the old air raid siren to test it this morning.
Air raid siren? What on earth are you going to do with one of those?
I found it in the station storeroom. Took it home, stuck it under the bed. Thought it might be worth something one day. Oh, damn it!
It's all right. It's just a nosebleed. Here, use my Yankee. It's clean.
Oh, thanks, Frank, thanks. Been getting like a bloody drain all day.
Hmm. So, if you don't recall, Howard was operating the railroad, and I believe after the train wreck, that's when he disappeared and, quote-unquote, lost his shoes. I guess it wants me to go this way. Or not. God damn it, dude. Just make a decision. That's the most indecisive light I have ever seen. Watch, there's probably not going to be anything up here. Yeah. Does not look like it.
How best, Graham?
Oh, maybe not.
Morning, Frank.
You look a little out of breath. What's up?
Bloody observatory gates have failed. I came to see if I could borrow a ladder.
Bloody hell, there's a 12-foot drop the other side of that wall.
I'm old, but I'm not useless, no. Can I borrow the ladder?
No one said you were useless. Reese?
Aye, Frank?
Fetch Graham the ladder, will you, lad? It's round the side of the barn.
Will do.
And you be careful. I don't want Stephen Appleton coming mithering round here because you've broken your neck.
And here you are again. Got something else for me. That way. I feel like I should probably go back real quick while I still can and go over that fence just to be sure there's nothing there that I could take a look at. Yeah, I'm gonna go just down over here.
Hi! I want a word with you!
Jeez, what the bloody hell are you doing?
What are you up to?
Get out of my way. This is important.
You've been with Lizzie. You mess with her, I'll knock your bloody block off, son.
I need to track the pattern. It's critical.
What are you talking about, Stephen? People are sick. Birds are dying. My cows are dead. Where's Kate?
Still up at the tower for all I know. I could recalibrate the radial coordinates on the primary oscillators. If that holds up...
Stephen, where's Kate? What's going on?
Just keep out of my way.
You know, I've decided that I'm just going to keep going this way. All the way down there, like, it seemed like it was pretty far into Frank's storyline when he was hearing on the radio that they were about to call in a strike. So I bet if I go over that fence, that'll be closer to the end. And if possible, I'd like to stay in chronological order, and going along this path feels like I'm doing that. So, before we go, or hopefully before we go to the final thing, whatever it might be, I can double back if necessary. Shit, okay. God, this is not easy. I'm not sure which one I want to do. So there's a pathway up here. There's also this. I'm going to check this out first. It looked like there was some sort of distortion over here. Nothing? Nah, there's something.
He never mentioned anything about them sickening yesterday.
I checked them last night on the way back, and they were fine. I woke up this morning, and the whole lot had gone. Tell me, Charlie, have you heard any birds today?
Well, I've not really been paying any attention.
That sister of mine reckons they're dropping out the sky all around the Reekin. And Dr. Wade reckons there's sick folk all over the village.
Meg said not to bother trying to get deliveries out. Set the quarantine in the whole valley. I reckon it's best we just sit it out. It'll all come right, Frank.
This'll all come right?
Yeah, right. I am sorry about your cows, Frank. But when things settle down, they'll see you all right. There's got to be provision for this sort of thing.
You want to listen to the radio more? Things don't seem like they're settling down at all. I tell you, Charlie, something big is happening.
I'm still trying to figure out exactly what Charlie's involvement in this story is. Like, I've seen him talking to Sam, and now Frank. You know, so he's been in Yawden and out here, but I'm not really sure exactly what his role is, like what he does. Like, you know, Sam is, I'm pretty sure, a car mechanic. You know, you've got Steven, who's a scientist. You have Wade, or Dr. Wade, who is a doctor, obviously. So yeah, I'm not really certain what Charlie does exactly. Seems like he just is the sidekick to everyone. Like, he just talks to people. Alright, where are we on the map? Last map didn't tell me. Alright, we're here on the Appleton's farm. Alright. I don't think I can go that way. Can I? Shit. Well, how do I get up there? There's gotta be something. Well, that's actually really frustrating. I'm not certain how I'm expected to get up there. There's definitely a phone. Huh. Maybe there's an alternate path. Oh, wait. I could have gone back. I just realized that. There are two sides to these. Shit.
There you go.
Oh, thanks, Frank. Let you get it out of the way. I don't know what happened. It just died on me.
Give it another go.
Oh, I only just put petrol in it as well. Robert's taken the other car into town. I wish he'd get back. He promised me that he'd be back this morning.
You think he's off on another bender?
Oh, I can't police him all the time, Frank. He's not a child.
What's going on, Lizzie?
Nothing.
You're seeing Stephen again, aren't you? You two can't keep pithering on like this. If Robert hasn't already worked it out, he soon will.
Oh, not if he carries on drinking the way he is. Shit. Pardon my French, but bloody shitting thing. Why won't it start?
Come on, I'll give you a lift.
And now it wants me to go that way. I wonder what's over here, though. Yachton Road. Let's just take a look at the map real quick. Alright, if I keep on going, I'm going to move on into Lakeside. So I'm going to go back down into here. So I'm pretty certain that if I keep going that way, I'm going to come across another storyline. I also think that another point of view character is probably going to be Lizzie. Wouldn't totally shock me. But I think Lizzie and Steven are going to be two other characters. Because there's six characters in total that this story focuses on. Obviously, we're currently on number three with Frank. Oh. Ah, there it is.
Got the telescope up and running again, but the pattern has burnt itself onto the lens. It's soaking up light and radiation, but not routing it anywhere. So I can only guess that it's using it as an energy source in its attempts to communicate. It needs more power. I wonder if I could boost the reception by using multiple towers.
This is definitely, like, in terms of story, it isn't, but this is definitely my favorite scenery up to this point. It's just like it's a really nice contrast to the previous two. Oh, we got something here.
Frank! Frank, for God's sake, stop!
Keep back, you bastard. I know what you've done.
Where's Lizzie? Where is she? I've got to find her.
You stay away. Someone's got to warn them. Someone's got to stop it.
You can't stop it. You have to understand. You hate me, I get that. But if we don't do this, it's not just the valley, it's everything, Frank. It's all gone.
You're talking bollocks.
You can't stop it! Jesus!
You take one step closer, I'll bash your bloody skull in, I swear to God.
All right, I'm going. But if you see Lizzie, tell her to get out, there's still time. Please, Frank, for her, not me.
If you're that bloody caring, you can save her yourself.
Don't you get it? I have to stay. Someone has to be here to confirm that everyone is dead.
That's really dumb. Like, if you're so ruthless to the point that you're willing to kill all of these people, but then you're... Like, couldn't it just defeat the purpose by letting one of them go? That seems stupid. And now there's a siren going off. Like, I just don't get it. It makes no sense to me. Oh, is it that way? Like, I can't hear it from there. I can certainly hear it from there. Oh, no, wait, I've already been here. Yeah, no, I climbed that before. All right, you know what? I'm going to take this opportunity to double back over in that direction, and then I'll come back over to the windmill. Oh, here we are.
Wade called me in about 6 weeks after, once he thought I could cope with knowing. Can I ever repay you for what you did?
She was a good woman, Frank.
The best.
You should come back to church. Back to the community. You're missed.
I hate him, Father. I can't get down on my knees and pretend otherwise. And I don't understand why you don't hate him, too.
I try my hardest not to, Frank. It goes against the job description somewhat. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for. The conviction of things not seen. We have to trust him. Even when his methods are hidden from view. Maybe see you on Sunday.
Alright, so apparently Frank's wife was... Frank's wife died somehow as well, I guess. How did I miss this one? Hold up. And that's where, yeah, okay. This is what I missed before. Because I could have climbed on top of that thing, and I would have walked up over here. Alright, well, I feel like an asshole now, because that was not a major plot point that would have ruined the chronology of everything. It just caused me to have to walk around a whole bunch. Not a big deal, it's just kind of annoying. My own fault, though. Alright, so, enough dicking around, time to get to that siren.
My name is Frank Jacob Appleton. And if you're listening to this, then maybe Stephen was right. And by sending the planes, he stopped it all getting worse. It's a beautiful morning.
Oh, Jesus, he's gonna kill himself.
I wasn't there when Mary died. I was too scared. So I went to the pub instead. What will be, Frank, she said. And I just want you to face it with me. And I didn't. But I will now. I will face it with you now, Mary. They're coming.
Oh, Jesus. Christ. So the airstrike did happen. Ah, that's rough. I am a little bit worried that I didn't find everything that I could have, is the only thing. Can't deny, that is very pretty. Damn. Whatever, that one takes place after this. I'm thinking whatever happened to him.